Speaking of stage fright, recently I was down south with my niece, and she'll always tell jokes, and I was like, if you, you know, tell a bad joke and no one laughs, just say tough crowd, you know. It'll work for the rest of your life, you're precocious, you're cute. And so she like told the joke and no one laughed, and she was like, tough crowd. And I was like, I didn't tell you to join Slipknot, but you know, like, the mask would be cute on you. So that being said, I'm reading a poem that I've been editing recently. There is a content warning I'd like to give folks. There's transphobia, rape, and murder referenced in this. So if anyone can't take that on, would like to leave, you know, please do. It's called Perpetual Slaying, Daughter, Sister, and Friend, an Epitaph. Future death was inevitable on the television screen in South Carolina, in my grandmother's living room. The face of murder is angry men. The look death gives is drunk on cheap beer. And the voice of violence is invisible until we're screaming. He is suspended over my urinal. He is the phantom dick we pack. He is Lincoln's blistering sun. He was like an ace bandage, that shredding skin after it's turned concrete from sweat, and a scar each one of us carries. When they raped him, they knew he was a roughneck too. They knew what he wanted for his birthday, and that he had sex with one of their ex-girlfriends. They knew he was a hard worker. They knew he had an accent like theirs and that he could ride mechanical bull. They knew he was the class clown. They knew he smoked cigarettes and that children loved him. When they murdered him on New Year's Eve, they knew how his face looked after mudbogging and that they were going to jail. They knew his expression while he was being raped. They knew where to find him, and that he laughed the loudest in movie theaters. They knew what his ribs sounded like when a fist pulverized them. They knew how honored he was to have a girlfriend, and that he referred to corn as a field of goldenrod. They knew they had to kill the single mother harboring him too. They knew Brandon was hiding under a bed, and that a baby was watching. So a poem's about Brandon Tino, which some of you might know through the film Boys Don't Cry, and I went to his grave on one of my tours with Transit. So that's it.